76-61. In fact, in the last four meetings, the visiting team has won the game. The opening tap was controlled by the Heels for a second, then to Cornelius for Miami in the white, orange, and green. Denise Bailey is making her first start of the season, number four in white, and she steals that offensive board and lays it in.
And that's exactly why she is starting. Katie Meyer saying that Bailey played with a lot of energy in practice, and she felt like she could have a big night tonight.
Watts for three, and she buries it.
Carolina picking up with some pressure. They went over that in shoot around, trying to get the trap on the defensive end. But on offense, Stephanie Watts likes to hide in the corners, and she will do exactly that. And if you go zone, your big man on the bottom has to be ready to step out and contest.
How about 70 made threes by Watts this season? She's attempted the second most three-pointers in the nation, as Key has the steal and the easy layup.
Harris Key's done an outstanding job of getting her team off to great starts on the offensive end, and this is even more important on the road.
It's going to be a foul against the Tar Heels, and Jamie Cherry, number 10.
You can already sense the pace of this game, and Carolina is going to want to play up-tempo because they are shorthanded in the post, so they'll often go small and want to get up and down the floor, where Miami may slow things down a little bit without Adrian Motley and look to be more deliberate on the offensive end.
Miami worked it to Bailey. Watts ran into her, and Watts has picked up the personal for North Carolina, her first. Opening moments of the first quarter from Coral Gables, Florida. Our officials tonight, Dee Cantner, Edward Sidlaski, and Norma Jones. Still trying to sort something out at the scorer's table.
I think they are straightening out the possession arrow.
So they're clear about that issue. Kane's ready to put it in play. This is Bailey. Wow, she's making the most of her first start this season as she hits the jumper and was fouled.
Bringing a lot of energy, and Shanice Bailey better hit that shot because Amaysa Hoff had Jamie Cherry on her back in the post right here. The one dribble pull-up, which is a move you practice in the gym on your own with the foul. Off to a hot start and much needed for Miami.
Just the 17th free throw attempt of the season for Bailey. She's made 14 of them. She is already above her season average of 2.3 points per game. Key will pull up.
Miami showing pressure, but rotating back into a zone. And Carolina able to get to the middle of the floor.
Bailey's pass was deflected. Kane's able to recover.
But Carolina will play a lot of switching man-to-man. But they have to be careful because you see the mismatch inside right now with Amaysa Hoff. That's what can happen.
It's Bailey again, the junior from Callahan, Florida, and a transfer from Florida Atlantic. Miami breaks up the play. Second effort is up and good. Coonan with the bucket for North Carolina.
And that's a good sign for Coonan. She's had to play extended minutes, only a freshman, but looked confident in making that tough move.
She struggled from the floor against Notre Dame, just 1 of 8 in 25 minutes. As she started against the Irish, they create the steal. Key slightly shaken up behind the play. Watts launching a three. On the weak side, kept alive. And North Carolina cashes it in. Destiny Walker, who got the board.
We talked about the back-to-back losses for Katie Meyer's team, but what they struggled with in ACC play, second chance points. They're giving up a lot of offensive rebounds and putbacks. So Katie Meyer, not happy to see that early in this game.
Miami scored just 48 points in that loss at Syracuse on Sunday. And that was a season low for the Hurricanes. Made just 4 of 20 three-point attempts. as Brittany Sykes had 29 points. Alexis Peterson had 24, and the Orange rolled to victory.
Yeah, Syracuse was in control the entire time. Miami just didn't look like themselves. They weren't aggressive.
So a three-pointer from Cornelius, who failed to score in that game against the Orange. Bailey seems to be everywhere on the court. It'll be another chance for the Canes working the offensive glass.
Denise Bailey is an incredible athlete.
Thomas went through the lane and got bumped.
One thing to keep an eye on offensively for Miami is Carolina is switching. Miami should be able to go inside. I mean, you can go inside to Hayes, to Hoff. The Tar Heels just don't have the height, the experience in the post to be able to contend.
That game against the Orange for Miami was their fifth straight against a ranked opponent. Hoff did not get the turnaround. Bailey, very springy under the basket.
Denise Bailey said, Adrian Motley who?
She is picking up the slack for her teammate. As we told you at the top of the broadcast, Motley unavailable for tonight, dealing with a family matter. Motley has started 105 straight games, 116 career games in a Miami uniform for Money Motley.
So dependable, and that is a dependable shot for Paris Keith. She loves the mid-range game. Miami went to a man-to-man defense in that possession, and Key is a great one-on-one scorer.
6 points now for Key. At the other end, it bounces out. Hoff recovers it to Cornelius. Kick out to Thomas, straight away for three. Offensive glass and up and good. Miami crashing the glass with Kiana Hayes.
Miami can do that whenever they want. With the size advantage, they should be able to rule the boards, get second chance points, and score in the paint on every possession.
Carolina with a 2-point lead into Watts. Hoff came over for the help, and Hayes the outlet to Cornelius. She wants a three. The box out, and Walker runs it up. Cherry. Bailey. Now she's taking balls away from her own teammates.
Man, what a start.
6 offensive rebounds for the Canes, although Key with a clean steal. 3-on-2 break. The individual effort from Key, and the basket is going to count.
What a move by Paris Key.
In right now, and the sophomore Key from Tarboro, North Carolina. Despite the miss, Key leads the way with 8 points for the Tar Heels. Averages almost 15 per game, and that is 9th in the ACC.
And keep in mind, she starts at the 4 position, so that is not what she plays. She played point guard most of her life.
Hoff from the Netherlands.
Good help defensively in the post.
And that'll lead to a bucket from Kiana Harris. Had to give it up, but traveled in the process. So it will be Miami basketball when we come back. The Tar Heels have the lead on the road.
For 40 straight years, 40
play. Paris Key leading the way for North Carolina with 8 points. And 9 for Shanice Bailey, getting her first start of the season. She's on the bench right now.
North Carolina showing the zone defense on the opening possession.
Driving all the way to the basket, Erica Davenport.
And that's a good sign for Katie Meyer. Davenport had a strong start to the season, but has since trailed off. She's usually dependable on the offensive glass and getting putbacks, but has not been very efficient.
This is a three from Walker. Destiny Walker's now made 35 three-point baskets on the season. And it's a 3-point lead for North Carolina. It is a traveling violation against Deanna Harris.
Going back to that last offensive possession for Carolina, as the ball is shifted, and they've done a good job of moving it here, Miami showing zone. Well, Cherry gets to the baseline, which is a weak side of that zone, and gets a nice kick to Walker.
Carolina working it around with 10 on the shot clock. Cherry gets a three.
Talking about a confident team, North Carolina is only averaging 64 points per game in ACC play. It's dipped from their 72 on the season. In the clip they're shooting right now, offense is really working well.
North Carolina is 9 of 13 from the floor. And the Tar Heels have made 3 of 5 three-point attempts. They'll take it inside and get the basket. Elisa Okoni with the contribution. She only averages about 2.5 points per game. Players on both rosters stepping up. Hoff and Cornelius. That's the Dutch connection.
You notice a trend for both of these teams. The offense is able to get to the middle of the floor. And if you do that, if you get to the paint, you've got options. So we'll see which team steps up to defend to keep the other out of the paint.
Cherry again. Inside the line, a 2 for Cherry.
And the defense has to collapse or has to help. The rotation is not there to get out on the shooters right now.
This is Hoff trying to muscle her way inside, denied by the Carolina D. They work it outside to Harris, and she's on target.
And Mesa Hoff is a tremendous passer and makes a good decision.
Thomas gets it back from Harris around the corner, tried to drop it off to Hoff, who was ready but deflected out of bounds by Destiny Walker.
The junior Jamie Cherry right here lighting it up from long range. The defense collapses and she is ready to shoot, and on this possession really makes something out of nothing. There's a fumble and the one dribble pull up from the baseline. As a junior, she is now the most veteran player available for Sylvia Hatchell. We mentioned that Hillary Fuller has retired from the game of basketball. Her collegiate career is over because of the persistent knee injuries.
She was trying to fight through a right knee injury. Did play 19 games this season, but could go no further after the game January 19th against Wake Forest.
And when you see her loss is in the half-court offense, because she's a great screener. She gets her teammates open. But if Carolina keeps this pace, they can run.
5-point lead for the Heels.
Small lineup here for North Carolina.
Cornelius off the Davenport screen all the way to the glass. Back out to Thomas. Goes inside. Second effort. Kane's had a chance. They'll get it back again.
Switching man-to-man by North Carolina.
Thomas hits the jumper.
I don't know how she got that off.
It was great work by Kiana Hayes and her teammates to keep it alive, and finally Thomas hits.
The switch on the screen, Davenport rolls, and I'll tell you this, it is not easy to shoot over the outstretched hands of Okoni. She's got some length.
Cherry is the player down for North Carolina. So she will end.
Definitely took a hit.
Yeah, she got tangled up with Erica Davenport. But it appears that Cherry is okay and ready to go in the lineup right now for North Carolina. Walker. Final minute of the first quarter. Shot clock at 10 for North Carolina. Cherry toward the rim. Too strong. Long outlet to Harris. Walker, the only player back for North Carolina. Knocked around, ball hit the end line, touched last by the Tar Heels, Miami ball. Nyjah Green has come in for Miami. Deanna Harris leaves the court. Thomas on the inbounds. Thomas got her defender in the air and made her pay.
Really quick, speedy, and once again able to get a piece of the paint.
Thomas now with 4 points, 2 of 5 from the floor. North Carolina shooting 65% in this first quarter, and the shot clock is down to 8, and the game clock for that matter. Out of bounds, 6 seconds to go on the clock.
Very, very wisely, as the leader on the floor looks to Watts and said, I missed you on that one, Watts, but I got you next time.
Key comes back in, 8 points in the first quarter. Paris Key tries to get position on the inbounds. Gets the shot away and hits it with 2 seconds left. And the desperation three-quarter court shot from Thomas.
Because North Carolina will play small, and they don't have a lot of experience coming off of the pine in the post with the loss of Hillary Fuller.
Shanice Bailey scored the first 9 points of the game for Miami to tie her season high. Driving to the basket, Davenport. Oh, Davenport, yes, it's Davenport.
Not enough communication there. If Carolina was switching, they did not do so in a timely manner.
How about Bailey? Steals it and lays it in. And a new season high, Shanice Bailey.
You reach your season high after a quarter of basketball. Pretty good night. Fighting around screens. This is the matchup that could be interesting with Paris Key at the 4 position.
Held ball situation. The arrow will favor North Carolina.
Shanice Bailey has set the tone for the Canes tonight with her athleticism, her hustle. I'm really impressed, because sometimes in your first start, you know, you might be a little nervous or have some jitters. She looks at home.
Stark contrast to her season average. She may have already earned a start in their next game based on her performance. Easy rebound for Thomas.
No transition defense here from North Carolina.
Watts. Key just beyond the free throw line. And a very soft bounce here at Watsco Center for Key.
I mean, Paris Key has a complete game. She can come off a screen. She can create her own shot one-on-one.
Bailey misses out of the corner. Walker. Walker gets the shot away in the old-school floater.
Beautiful floater. And Destiny Walker has not played healthy. She's been dealing with a right knee soreness. Missed a game, missed a Wake Forest game, but she looks to be healthy tonight.
Cherry, the steal up to Key, and she'll lay it in uncontested.
Really impressed with North Carolina's ability to push tempo, to speed up Miami. Great start.
14 points for Key. And that leads all scorers. She's 7 of 8 from the floor for Paris Key, the sophomore. She's a transfer from Vanderbilt.
Paris Key is playing at the 4, so what she does is forces teams to put their post player in pick and roll situations, which many of them aren't used to doing, and having to guard on the perimeter. 7 for 8. She does it 4 shots. She knows where her bread is buttered, and she gets to those points on the floor, and she scores.
This is Cornelius open. Bailey had it for a second. Now it gets deflected all the way back out to Cornelius.
Let's see if Miami can get a post touch. Look at Amaysa Hall. She's got carry on her in the post.
Green drives. Dropped it off to Hoff. It's like an offensive foul against Miami. It will be against Green.
Katie Meyer talked in shoot around about using their size and Miami having the advantage, especially with the switching man-to-man. And the Canes haven't done that so far in this game.
Watts, a difficult shot, and she used the glass effectively. It's an 8-0 North Carolina run. Hoff flings it into the corner to Bailey. Gives it up, Cornelius.
Long rebounds lead to transition.
1-on-3 for Walker. Unable to get the shot on the cylinder. It's going to be off of North Carolina, Kane basketball.
You know, Stephanie Watts has a knack for finding angles off of the glass. Right here, she's pushed outside the lane, but the nice old school hook shot slash floater there off the glass. And she said she has always practiced those shots. She loves trick shots, and she makes them in the game.
Watts, who leads the team in scoring, almost 19 per game. Second best in the ACC. Green misfires. Miami working hard offensive glass. Prather couldn't convert. All the way up ahead to Walker, who got fouled by Green.
Miami may need to start to send a couple back on the defensive end in transition because Carolina is full steam ahead. Look at Paris Key. Perfect pass to Walker, who has already beat the defense down the floor. And Miami may need to start rotating back a little sooner.
72% from the line for Destiny Walker, the sophomore from Orlando, Florida, as Kiana Harris comes back in for Miami. Harris has 5 points. Walker originally from the Bahamas. And North Carolina has traveled there to play some games in the Bahamas.
Only a sophomore, but a ton of experience her freshman year. So she's considered a veteran.
Had a 32-point game this year against Florida A&M. Hoff in traffic. Gets some help. That turnaround bounces out. Everything but the bucket from Prather. Walker from the wing. Off pass is picked off by Cherry. Watts before she can shoot it. An offensive foul against North Carolina as Cherry continued after the pass.
The pace of this game is at the advantage of the North Carolina Tar Heels. They are in a groove, both offensively and defensively, getting steals, forcing turnovers, and Miami's been vulnerable to turnovers. You would think a team that has a Jessica Thomas and Adrian Motley in the backcourt would have a lot of ball security, but they've actually struggled some in league play with that.
41% the first half from the floor. Bailey the shot, and she's fouled. Smith came over to defend. Bailey hit the shot and the chance at the three-point play.
Olivia Smith, the freshman, makes a freshman mistake here, fouling the jump shooter. And Bailey is ready for whatever challenge you throw at her tonight. Unbelievable performance.
Shanice Bailey now has 14 points. 6 of 8 from the floor, and she's made both of her free throw attempts. Both completing three-point plays for Bailey. Poonen rattles in and out. Poonen's only made 8 three-pointers on the season. Entry to Hoff. Let the defender slide on by the Mesa Hoff.
And Katie Meyer wanted her team to pick up full court. They did not get that notice early enough.
Hoff was one of the bright spots against Syracuse on Sunday. 12 points, 4 rebounds. Shoots it well in ACC play, 60%. Paris Key shoots it well also.
It's the night of the transfer. Shanice Bailey, a transfer from Florida Atlantic. Paris Key, a transfer from Vanderbilt.
16 points for Key. Cornelius kicks it out. Two players diving for the loose ball. And now 4 minutes to go in the first half. Deflected by Watts.
That's got to be a high pass for Hoff.
Smith. Watts going for the rebound over Bay.
The numbers there. Key, Walker, Cherry, Watts, everyone involved.
About the last 2.5 games for Paris Key. 58 points. We're only midway through our game this evening from Coral Gables.
After their loss to Notre Dame, Muffy McGraw said, wow, Paris Key is an outstanding player, and Hoff has got to finish that.
Miami leading on the boards, 23-11. They got 13 offensive rebounds. Carolina in possession. That's a foul against North Carolina. Coney.
But you have to applaud the effort of Coney, because that's an area that they will need her to improve immediately. Setting screens and getting her teammates open on the offensive end.
She's a freshman from Houston, Texas, but now has two personal fouls. Bailey came flying in after the miss from Mortensen. We'll keep it at this end of the floor, and the foul is against Cherry.
Yeah, Carolina wins zone, and Miami is screening the zone.
So that's the third on Cherry. Fifth in the quarter, so now two shots for Bailey. So Cherry leaves, Walker comes in, Bailey at the line. That's her first miss from the free throw line.
You may say, why did Sylvia Hatchell keep Cherry in the game? Well, you look at her bench, those numbers we mentioned earlier, all the freshmen and sophomores, not a lot of options as this young team continues to grow. And on the road, it's particularly difficult.
15 points now for Bailey, the only Kane in double figures. Walker launches the three, and she gets it.
Miami applying pressure, but not getting the turnovers.
Walker is 2 for 2 from beyond the arc. Mortensen the response, and a three for Miami. That pass sails out of bounds.
Going back to North Carolina, doing a good job of passing out of pressure. See, the trap never closes, so Paris Key can see the entire floor. And then lining up for the outside shot was Destiny Walker. And Paris played point guard at Vanderbilt. That is the position she knows best. So even though her position indicates that she's a forward for this team, she sees the floor so well.
Cornelia stepping into a three in rhythm. Back-to-back three balls for Miami. And it's a one-point game. Watts on the run. Side steps the defender. Hits the deck in a foul against Miami.
You saw a deep sigh of relief from Laura Cornelius on this shot. Steps into it in transition. And the reason why she was so relieved is she was 0 for 7 against Syracuse, 0 for 5 from long range. And without Adrian Motley, she has to be an offensive threat.
Don't forget, coming up, it's the Hardys Halftime Report. Catch you up on the happenings around the ACC. Check that scoreboard and break down the first half between North Carolina and Miami. High-paced, high-scoring. Six points for Watts, 2 of 6 from the floor. Two-point lead for the Tar Heels. Cornelius. Unable to grab that pass. Out of bounds. Katie Myers taking this program to the postseason 7 straight years. And now they go with the pressure. Smith. Weak side. Cornelius had the box out. She runs it up 3-on-3, tries to do it herself, and does! Laura Cornelius, who last year against North Carolina in a winning effort in Chapel Hill had 13 points, 8 rebounds, and 7 assists. This is key. Final minute of the second quarter. Tied at 42. North Carolina led by as many as 8 in this first half. Thomas took a tumble after the shot attempt. Went off of North Carolina.
Well, we witnessed the outside attack from Laura Cornelius, but she's just making smart plays here. Attacks the rim. Paris Key not really in position to defend. And I think Miami's got to do that more.
Semifinals of the ACC tournament before losing to eventual champion Notre Dame. Shot clock is down to 5 for Thomas. To Bailey as she fell. Bailey does fall and travels. There's only a second left on the shot clock. And just over 30 seconds to go in our second quarter. So Miami has come back to tie this game. A couple of threes from Cornelius late. This is key.
Off of the wrong foot. Oh, my God.
Now she's going for style points and a timeout Miami. 14.2 seconds to go.
I thought Carolina would save it for the...
17 times this season now into double figures for Key. Tonight she's done it in the first half. Bailey leads the way for Miami with 15. Cornelius, that's a tough one. Very high degree of difficulty, and she beats the clock. Outscoring their opponents 16 times in 19 games. Cornelius trying to hit Hoff off her fingertips into Walker. Cherry.
Someone's got to come back to the basketball against pressure. If you are Miami, you've got to bring players to the ball. That's too hard of a pass to make.
Bailey came flying in after the miss by Hayes. Looks like the foul's going to be on Bailey. So it'll be the second on Bailey. You'll recall that Miami against Syracuse scored 48 points while they've got 44 starting the third quarter. Much better result tonight on their home court, where Miami is 8-2 overall, 1-2 in conference play at Watsco Center. He hit the cutter, Cherry. Contact as she drove, and Bailey might have picked up another quick one.
Good movement here without the basketball. Key has nowhere to go. Jamie Cherry makes the read right to the middle of the floor.
So the third personal on Bailey puts Cherry at the free throw line. Pretty good from the line, 80%, but beyond that, Cherry is second in school history in career free throw percentage, 81%.
Takes a lot of time in the gym. She makes her second to mount numbers like that.
So Cherry's up to 7 points. Thomas backs it out. Hoff. Thomas. Dropped it to Hoff. Skillful.
North Carolina was in a zone. Good decision there by Jessica Thomas. This team needs her leadership. Rather quiet first half for her.
6 points for Hoff. And then Coonan travels for North Carolina.
Good use of the ball fake there by Thomas. Gets the shoulders up, draws Watts, and on the backside, she's got Hoff. And Miami did not do a good job of getting the ball into the post. Post-entry passing was challenging for the Canes. So let's see if they can make the more use of that height inside.
Cornelius to Hoff. gets her own miss and lays it in. And there's the size. Hoff, 6'3", sophomore from the Netherlands with the bucket. Cherry. Layup from Koonin.
Jamie Cherry looking to be more of a distributor on this year's team, and she has gotten her team involved tonight.
How about Harris on the drive, angling to the rim and scoring. And the last three baskets for Miami have been very close to the rim. Good proximity for Katie Meyer's team. 2-point lead. Koonin trying to tie it. Hoff is not having it.
Now, this is what you want to see if you're Katie Meyer. Mesa Hoff asking for the basketball, and I'm okay with her passing it to her, even though she's got a defender there, because it's a small double team. And if she catches it high and keeps it high, like she did, she can score.
Cherry hit the deck after contact and a foul. That's Hayes. First personal for the senior from Marietta, Georgia. Cherry ran the baseline, tried to get it to Watts. Stolen back. Thomas. Run down by Hayes. Trying to hit Harris. Went through the net. On the bottom of the net. Now Miami regroups and settles down. Cornelius trying to shed her defender.
I love the way Laura Cornelius has been asserting herself, starting with the second half of the second quarter. Looks very determined to get to the rim, being aggressive, playing off instinct.
Should have known that this one might go down to the final minutes. Three of the last four games between the teams decided by 3 points or less. Thomas.
She's gotten that all day. North Carolina has not covered that middle pick and roll very well on Thomas.
Offensive glass work by North Carolina. First bucket for Otoni. As you check out the box score. Thomas, little mid-range. No problem.
So under control. And again, great use of the ball fake. Carolina's trying to force turnovers, so they're going to jump with every head fake, every head pump.
8 points now for Thomas. Couple of recent jumpers. Watts extending the range. Thomas, open. Walker backs it out.
Jessica Thomas is going to slow the tempo just a little bit right here.
4-point lead for Miami. Just over 5.5 minutes to go in our third quarter. Tom Rooney, LaChana Robinson, our outstanding production crew. And that's an outstanding move from Harris, determined to get to the bucket.
Take over time for Jessica Thomas.
She is now into double figures with China with 10 points.
Jessica Thomas is always the last player to leave the gym, and here's where it pays off. On the pick and roll, she's got the pull up off of the bounce, sizes up the defense, uses the hesitation move so nicely. And right here, just determined with the kick off of the glass, and this is the punch that Miami needs. She has scored their last 6 points.
Is it eight? It is.
North Carolina has plenty of capable defenders. Someone has to decide that that's it for Thomas.
Key shot rattles out. It was a Coney fighting for the rebound. 12 points for Jessica Thomas with China. Miami is on a 10-2 run.
And that is what has been so impressive about the ACC is the experience across the board. Every team has got veteran backcourts, and that makes it tough for a team like Carolina that has somewhat struggled in the league. Some of the younger teams are the teams that are really off the slow start.
Thomas has scored the last 8 points. Making 11.
No communication in transition. If you're Sylvia Hatchell, you're saying to your team, we took a timeout to stop Thomas, and then we lose her in transition.
Key trying to get rid of it. Out of bounds off of Miami, which is on a 13-2 run with 4:16 to go in the third.
This is just a good find by Laura Cornelius. A difficult pass across the court. Hard for the defense to recover.
That's Davenport. Flag for the personal.
Seen a lot of fight from Okoni tonight. She is really growing in her role now, full time in the post without Hillary Fuller. Showing a lot of toughness.
5 team fouls in the quarter for Miami. Puts Okoni at the free throw line. She has not spent a lot of time there this season as Coonan comes back in. Alisa Okoni just attempts numbers 17 and 18 on the season. One of two out of bounds, Miami ball. How about the Hurricanes and Thomas, 8 of 11 shooting in this quarter alone. Difficult pass inside and caught. The turnaround's off the glass. And good. Fiona Hayes.
That is now 28 points in the paint for Miami. They have ruled the paint both off the dribble penetration and started to get some moves in the post as well.
For a pony shot, Carolina player Destiny Walker sitting on the baseline.
This is where Carolina is experiencing a little bit of a lull. Paris Key is on the bench. She tends to have a more quiet second half than first half. So we will see how they can get things going. But it's very good that they've got to the free throw line this early. That'll help.
Key has only taken one shot in the quarter as Mortensen returns for Miami. She's got a three-pointer to her credit with Walker at the line. North Carolina, 7 of 11 as a team from the free throw line tonight, but trailing by 10, largest lead of the game. That's deflected out of bounds by Walker.
If you are North Carolina defensively, you have to find Jessica Thomas and start to get some stops on this end of the floor.
The inbounds. There's four players grabbing for it. No ball situation. It's going to be North Carolina ball.
Let's go, Miami. Come on, Kane.
Canes have led by 12 in this half. Keep in mind, North Carolina led by 8 in the first half. The game was tied at 44 at halftime. Cherry, some nifty dribbling. And she earns free throws. She ran into Kiana Hayes.
It's really tough to stop Jamie Cherry, but she makes a decision that she's going to get to the rim here. Uses a little bump screen, but a straight line really to the rim where Hayes fouls her. And let's not forget that Cherry was a tremendous scorer in high school, so she knows how to put up a lot of points and can be a volume scorer, but has tried to take more of a leadership role in passing the ball, assists this season to get her young team some confidence.
She's from Cove City, North Carolina. Went to West Craven High School, scored over 3,200 points in her high school career, and has that free throw. Thomas, a sizzling quarter. Defense! 15 points overall for Thomas, tied with Bailey for the team lead. Shot clock is at 5. Thomas lets it go. Cornelius, fresh shot clock. Harris on the drive.
Yep, I felt that was coming. That's going to be a technical foul on Harris. Keep your eyes on Harris, who has the ball in her hands right here. After she scores, a little taunting action there, you know, light. But I think the officials want to nip it in the bud. She actually did a little bit earlier, so may have gotten a warning. We don't know. Just trying to get her team hyped up.
So that puts Walker at the line for the technical. Harris does have 9 points and is 4 of 6 from the floor, but the technical foul and a couple of free throws for Carolina.
That's the kind of energy Miami plays with. You know, it was nothing, and it actually wasn't as much in the face of the opponent, but, you know, that's how they play, with that type of energy. That's how Katie coaches. That's a staple of their team, their identity.
That pass was not deflected. Miami ball.
Defensively, good job by Miami. The last time Cherry got all the way to the basket, that time the defense collapsed and they forced a turnover.
Cornelius behind the line. It's a 3. Best 3-point shooter by percentage on this Miami team, and she's got the loose ball. Cornelius. Harris ran into Key. Harris Key, personal foul, 2nd.
Offense really flowing for the Canes. Just no defense there by North Carolina. You have to move with a sense of urgency, especially because Cornelius has shown towards the end of the second half that she can score outside, inside.
2nd 3 of the game for Cornelius. She's in double figures with 10 points. Harris up and under.
Textbook breaking the trap by Miami.
Harris becomes the 4th Miami player to get the double figures in scoring tonight.
This season, Carolina has been able to play well in stretches, but staying focused for a full 40 minutes has been a bit of a challenge. But Cherry hoping to change that tonight.
They needed that one. Had been just 2 of 9 in field goal attempts in the quarter for North Carolina before the cherry bomb. Miami, conversely, 12 of 16. You can make that 13 of 17 from the floor in the quarter.
And that's there all day long.
Cherry again. Cornelius. Thomas with the crossover. Ends up with a ball for 3. Fouled on the 3-point shot attempt.
And take a look at Miami working on the offensive end. Carolina tries to trap it. What do you do when you have 2 defenders there? Find the open man on the baseline. Harris wide open. And then on the next possession, good read there as you get the switch on the pick and roll. Thomas recognizes the mismatch and Hayes gets the easy score at the rim.
First time Miami has gone to the free throw line in the quarter. First time Thomas has been at the line in the game. And Miami starting to extend that lead late in the 3rd. Thomas will get 1 more, fouled on the 3-point attempt.
One of the biggest differences for Miami here in the 3rd quarter is they've taken care of the basketball. They had 10 turnovers at the half, only 2 here in the 3rd quarter. One.
14 points in the quarter for Thomas. On the other side for North Carolina, Key is 0 for 2 in shooting in this quarter after leading the team in scoring in the first half. Coney doubled. Key driving baseline. Pass in tight quarters. Held ball situation. Whistle stops play, and Miami's getting it back.
North Carolina struggling on the offensive end compared to what we saw in the first half. And you have to credit Miami's defense. They have not given Paris Key much room to work with. They focused a lot on her defensively because she's been the catalyst.
Key had 18 points in the first half and nothing in this third quarter. Mortensen spins. Deflected away. Coonan grabs it. It's only 6 seconds on the game clock. Cherry up ahead. Walker the catch. And she used the glass and spun it in to beat the clock. Third quarter for Jessica Thomas, number 3 in white. Miami outscoring North Carolina 31-17 in the third period. Coonan behind the line. Key able to tie up Harris. It is Miami basketball. As we start the fourth quarter. We were tied at halftime, but Key was shut out in the third quarter and only attempted 2 shots.
Yeah, really, the Miami defense was swarming Paris Key, but she often struggles in the second half. It's like she plays a whole game in the first half when you look at her numbers, and then you wonder how much energy she has left as Carolina has not been able to go deep in their rotation.
Thomas. Pass deflected and taken by Walker.
We've seen both teams mixing it up defensively. Some zone, some man, trying to keep each other off balance.
Walker misses, tried to get that miss. Cornelius with it for Miami. Canes led by as many as 16 in that third quarter.
Getting in the hall. Oh, never mind. I thought they were going to try to get it into the Mesa Hall, but Cornelius said, my time.
Third three of the game from Cornelius on 6 attempts and 13 points for Laura Cornelius on Dutch night.
Yeah.
For her and Hoff. And she gets the rebound and is able to save it to Thomas. Hoff has 8 points, Cornelius with 13, 21 total from the Dutch duo.
We talked about Jessica Thomas, but it's also been the aggressiveness of Laura Cornelius that has changed things in terms of the momentum for the Miami Hurricanes. Started at the end of the first half. And I really think that Cornelius is going to be a special player in the ACC. She has gotten good experience. She can score inside out. She's an outstanding passer. But she's still learning. And that's the thing that you kind of forget with her. She's only a sophomore.
Cornelius got shut out in the box score. No points, no rebounds against Syracuse. So you knew she was determined tonight, especially on Dutch night.
That's right.
Back down. Cherry thought about that three. Looking off the screen, and now Key. Key with the three. And will that ignite her game in the fourth quarter?
Still plenty of time left in this game. But you notice the pace is not to Carolina's liking like it was in the first half.
Thomas. She's off target.
Once again on Coney.
You like her game inside. She really never quits on any of those rebound possibilities.
Yeah, and she has no choice at this point but to grow up on this young team. And she's 6'3". She's got incredible length. And again, they need some kind of presence on the interior. And she's getting there.
Key. Cornelius runs it down. Just flicks it up to Thomas. She's got eyes for the rim. Free throw's coming.
The change of speed is so difficult. You can see it happen, but good luck keeping in front of it right here. Just blows by Key, who looked like she was in position to defend, but no.
Third foul against Key. Thomas, 3-for-3 from the line. Those free throws, prior to that one, came on an attempted three out of the corner that she missed but was fouled right in front of her own bench.
Jessica Thomas has an incredible work ethic. A lot of respect for the time she puts into the gym. She is a rather quiet leader, but when the game is on the line, you'll see her get fired up. She plays with so much heart.
She's above her season average of 12.6, 18 points on the night, hasn't missed a free throw. Six and a half minutes to go in regulation. Coney had to save it back to Walker. And that's a three that North Carolina needed desperately.
Boy, the Tar Heels keep fighting, making something out of nothing.
Walker is 3-for-3 from beyond 20 feet. 9 inches away. Hayes tried to get it back. Bounces up to Key. There's Watts. Back to Miami as we run up and down the court. Thomas waiting for reinforcements. Watts is a name we haven't mentioned much recently.
Yeah, I was thinking the same thing when you said that.
McConey clears to Cherry. In fact, Watts has just 6 points as the leading scorer for North Carolina.
Oh, man.
Oh. Key driving.
Good patience by Cherry. I thought that she should have turned and shot it, but she saw a better opportunity with Key cutting to the rim.
23 points for Paris Key.
But can North Carolina get a stop? They've gotten a couple in the last few possessions.
How about Cornelius stepping back with confidence? 4 of 7 from three-point territory for Cornelius. He was fouled on the shot, and she's got a chance at a three-point play. North Carolina hanging in against the Canes.
No quit in the North Carolina Tar Heels. They are trying to knock off for the game of basketball. Sylvia Hatchell coming up on an impressive milestone in her career. And, you know, she often talks about just how much more patient she is now at this point in her coaching career, especially with a young team. A lot of that has to do with her battle with leukemia and how much she learned about patience in that process. And she's actually donating an exercise space to the cancer center where she received her treatment. She said there was one thing that was missing, and she said a place to exercise. She had to find a place to do that, so she is making a donation so that other cancer patients have that.
Her team wants to run. Up ahead, Walker. Try to dribble it off her foot, out of bounds.
Tough break, but a lot of energy here from the Tar Heels. I mean, you got to respect their fight.
Should also mention that Katie Meyer is closing in on 300 career wins. Katie's got 297 in 16 years as a head coach.
really love what Katie Meyer has done, and a player in the ACC at Duke, an outstanding player, and it has really just turned Miami into just a program that you expect to make the NCAA tournament every year, top 25, just battling for ACC championships year in and year out.
Well, she was an All-American at Duke back in 1990. Shot clock is at 5 for Thomas and the Canes. So pull it up. That's a 2. Dee Cantor was right on top of it. I think she motioned over to the scorer's table. She might want to take a peek at that.
And that was contested.
It is a 2 on the scoreboard. Watts with the shot. It's been a tough night for Watts. 6 points and now 2 of 9 and 2 of 10 now from the floor for Watts. Came in as the top scorer for the Heels, averaging almost 19 per game. Traveling violation back to North Carolina.
Jessica Thomas just pulls up and looks like that right toe may have been on the line. Destiny Walker got a high hand, but needed to be a little closer.
Thomas now 22 points. 3:15 to go in the fourth. Watts trying to get free for a shot. Gives way to Cherry. Gets by the defense and lays it in. points for Cherry on 4 of 9 shooting. That includes a couple of three-point baskets. Thomas. That's the sweet spot, but she misses this time. Cherry in transition. She scores! And a chance at the three-point play.
You can just feel the momentum for North Carolina. They do not want to give up on this game. Contact there. Cherry attacking the rim. She's made good passing decisions. Now she says, I'll have the quarterback keeper for 2 and a possible 3.
3 of 4 from the line of the game for Cherry. Of 17 from the line for North Carolina. One of the better free throw shooting teams in the conference at 70%.
And free throws really count on the road.
Shot clock at 8 for Cornelius. Another three-pointer, her 5th of the ball game.
And I thought it would be Miami's post play that would come up big in this game, but it's been their backcourt really making major plays, but some of them in the paint.
Notice that brace in the right knee for Watts. They're slightly injured in the game against Notre Dame. Bruised that knee. And you think maybe LaChina, that might be affecting her tonight. Despite that basket, she's now just 3 of 11 from the floor.
Yeah, it may be causing her some soreness.
All right, we'll step aside for just a moment. It's a 10-point game.
Follow your teams like never before. Stream live games with Fox Sports Go. To join the conversation, interact with other fans, and check out exclusive content, go to our social media pages from Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and everything in between. And for exclusive video content and insights, go to foxsportssouthwest.com. Follow your teams wherever you go.
88-78. Miami in front. We were tied at 44 at halftime. Thomas will use that clock. Cherry came out to defend. Fourth on Cherry. Just a second on the team, so the Heels have some fouls to give before Miami will be shooting.
Yeah, Jamie Cherry's trying to tell her team, I've got 4 fouls. She said, I got 4. She's trying to let her team know.
She's one of three North Carolina players in double figures. Key leads the way with 26. And she commits the foul. So that's now the fourth on Key. Third team foul. Need to get to five to put Miami at the line.
You got to think of this stretch that Miami has been on since January 5th. They have played five straight ranked opponents: NC State, Notre Dame, Virginia Tech, Louisville, Syracuse, and then they have to play tonight without Adrian Motley. So they have been tested. And definitely responding when needed in this game.
No look pass. Cornelius sent it inside to Hayes.
Yeah, that was all ball by Stephanie Watts. Good look there, but Watts using that length, that's all ball.
Walker reaches in, a second reach in, and a foul against Walker. So now shots for Miami with that fifth team foul for North Carolina. That's not who you want at the line. She's 5 for 5 tonight from the free throw line.
You have to think about the depth we've seen from Miami tonight. We've seen Shanice Bailey go off. We've seen Jessica Thomas. Laura Cornelius has had her moments. And think of how good Amesa Hoff has been in ACC play. We've seen Kiana Hayes put up big numbers. So this is a team. And don't forget, they're without Adrian Motley. A different player could step up every night and make big plays. They've got a lot of weapons.
Sonny, you've been in that situation before. Your star player goes down, and everybody feels responsibility to make up for that player. Cherry on a very nice drive if you get to the rim, an immediate timeout. But in that situation, sometimes you stepped up tonight, Michelle.
Yeah, we've seen contributions across the board. Shanice Bailey probably the most impressive, because now that we know what she's capable of, the expectations go up for her. But the sophomore Laura Cornelius as well. You know, she just really showed a lot of determination to get her game back on track tonight.
Shanice Bailey scored 15 points tonight. We're not done. 118 to go. Her average on the season was 2.3. She's running ahead of the field. Bailey the lay-in. And that seems appropriate.
Well executed by Katie Meyer, coming out of that timeout, going long.
Watts with the quick trigger. Cornelius up to Harris.
Good job by Miami, taking time off of the clock, spacing the floor, making it hard for Carolina to get to them to foul. And right here, Kiana Hayes with quite an arm with the long pass to Shanice Bailey right on target. He couldn't have drawn that up more perfectly.
So for Key, she committed the personal foul. That's going to be her fifth. So disqualified with those five personal fouls. Quite a night, though, for Paris Key. Again, the numbers for Key, 26 points as she leaves. So the last three games, 21 points, 21 points, and 26 points.
She's put the ACC on notice that she is a player that can score at will, and you're going to have to really dedicate some serious defensive effort to slowing her down, not only in her scoring, but her passing.
68 points in the last three games?
Well, math
sounds. Does that sound good?
Yeah, sounds about right. My math's not good, so I'll trust yours.
A word of encouragement from Andrew Calder, a longtime assistant for Coach Sylvia Hatchell.
Yeah, a lot of
teaching. He's been here every step of the way with Sylvia.
Absolutely, right there. Right-hand man. A lot of teaching going on with this staff and this young team.
Cherry got bumped. That was Kiana Hayes picking up the foul. Revisit the scoreboard from tonight, LaChina.
And it looks like Notre Dame pulled it out in South Bend by 4 over Duke. And Notre Dame returning home after playing 10 of 12 games on the road. So they'll enjoy some home cooking for a while. Final, Virginia big on Virginia Tech. Florida State over Georgia Tech. But nice fight there by the Yellow Jackets. Wake Forest, their third in a row as they get the win over BC. NC State over Pitt. And then Louisville over Clemson.
Well, you know, Wake, we did that game last week, last Thursday, where they went to Chapel Hill and won. They had not won there since 1991. And North Carolina had won 19 in a row at home against Wake Forest, and Jen Hoover's team got the victory. A foul with 46.9 to go.
Back to when Jen Hoover played on that team, that last one in Chapel Hill. And keep your eyes on the Lisa Pena and Alex Sharp, two players that are making some big noise for the Deacs. But it's so hard to make the climb in the ACC because when you look at those teams, those at the top, the ranked teams, I believe it's nine that have an RPI of 50 or higher. That's just incredible.
You're exactly right. And seven ranked in the top 25, and that includes this Miami team. Don't forget the doubleheader Sunday. There you see all the pertinent information. It will involve these Tar Heels as they will host NC State at 3 o'clock. Wake Forest and Duke to precede that game.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to seeing NC State up close and personal. I'll tell you, there's a lot of talk about their backcourt. Maya Spencer is spectacular, but Chelsea Nelson has impressed me. Her skill set, her versatility. Wes Moore has special players in her.
Cherry, she's got a three. And North Carolina.
Sylvia Hatchell is very familiar with, spends a lot of time there and thinks the world of their basketball following in the community, but the ACC tournament will be a hot ticket because the venue is smaller than that of what we're used to at Greensboro Coliseum, so you need to call today because it's going to be a battle for the best.
We're celebrating 40 years of the ACC Women's Tournament, but China got to play in that wonderful event in her days at Wake Forest.
I did, and so did Katie Meyer. I actually remember her telling us a story about her freshman year and how her parents traveled to the ACC tournament and did a pig picking. She said they had a pig picking celebration, a big meal, and they actually got beat by Wake Forest. Lisa Stockton, who Katie Meyer worked with at Tulane, hit a big shot, but she said, I blame my parents for the pick picking. I think that's why we lost. And she said they were upset with me. They didn't realize after we lost, it was time to go home. That was the end of the tournament.
Miami has not missed a free throw in the second half. 13 of 13 for the Canes.
And that's how you close a game. When you have to hit free throws to stay in front, do that under pressure. That's big.
Final 20 seconds, and Harris lays it in.
That's 100 points for the Hurricanes.
Miami scored only 48 on Sunday against Syracuse. Tonight is a different story as Walker drops a three. Final 10 seconds. And the Miami fans and Katie Meyer can celebrate a victory.